Welcome students to Rushmore International School. I am Abhilasha Shivastav. We hope that you and your family are doing well and taking necessary precaution towards health, hygiene and maintaining social distance, as well as suggesting others to follow the same. We hope for your well-being. Today we are going to start with English language. We live in a society, and in that society there are many people, and to communicate, to talk to them, we need a medium to exchange what we are thinking, to tell them and to gain the knowledge what they are thinking, right? And that exchange, we need a medium for that, and that medium could be signs, symbol, number, words, etc. Or in simple words, we can say we need a language, right? See, when one person or like I, when I'm talking, we deliver it in a form of speech. That means when we speak something and it is a proper sentence, it is in the form of speech. Speech has 8 classification. That speech is divided under 8 classification, namely noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, conjunction, preposition, and lastly interjection. These are the 8 classification or 8 parts of speech. Today we are going to discuss conjunction. Conjunction, what's your function? Let's see what is the function of conjunction. See, it rhymes. Conjunction is a word that connects. Two things are there. It connects words. Connects what? Words. Phrases, that means a group of words is a phrase, sentence to each other. What does this connect? It connects words, it connects phrases, it connects sentences to each other. Some common conjunctions are and, which we very commonly use, or, but. These are very common conjunctions. Let's take one by one to understand these conjunctions. Let's take the first conjunction, and. What is the purpose of and? It joins two similar ideas. It joins two similar ideas. Like this and that. Bread and butter. Similar idea. Milk and honey, right? They are very similar ideas, they are very similar. We are doing a similarity in them. That means we are keeping it together. That in the class, Rohan and Sameer are friends. They are similar friends, both are friends, right? It joined similar ideas. Let's see some examples to get a better picture. I am tired. I am hungry. I am tired. I am hungry. Two sentences. Now we are going to use the conjunction and. When we use the conjunction to add some statement or two statements, we reduce the statement or we eliminate or we remove some words when we use the conjunction. Let's see. I am tired and hungry. I am tired and hungry. See, we remove the repetitive word. The repetitive words I am, because I am was also over here. So we eliminated these two words. I am tired and hungry. That means it is the state. very tired and I'm very hungry. Similarity of idea. Let's take the next one. I did my homework. I cleaned my room. Two statements. I did my homework. I cleaned my room. Let's use the convention and. I did my homework and cleaned my room. I did my homework and I cleaned my room. I did both the things. Right? Who is the doer of both the action? I did my homework as well as I cleaned my room. Moving further, let's take another convention, the next convention, but. What is the purpose of but? Joins two contrasting. What is contrasting? Opposite ideas. The purpose of and was to join similar ideas. The purpose of but is to add different ideas or opposite ideas. Let's see. Not this, but that. I want this pen, not that pen. Not apples, but oranges. I like apples. I don't like apple, but I like oranges. Let's see some example to get a clear picture. I looked everywhere. I could not find my book. I looked everywhere. I could not find the book. Let's use the conjunction but. I looked everywhere, but I could not find my book. I looked everywhere. But the opposite, I was not able to find my book. Moving further, see the ideas are contrasting or not. Moving further. He is small. He is strong. Now both the things are contrasting. Small, he is strong. See, often we think that things or items which are very small are very weak or very fragile. But here it is contrasting. He is small but strong. The person we are talking, he is quite small, but he is very strong, right? Whenever we think about something small, we immediately link it with something weak, right? But here, it is totally contrasting, or totally saying opposite of it, that he is small, but he is strong. This was the conjunction but and we used conjunction but in the statement. Moving further. Now we have the third conjunction or. What is the purpose of or? Shows a choice between two or more options. It shows choice between two or more options. Let's see. Coffee or tea? Coffee. What would you prefer? Coffee or tea? Right or wrong? This answer could be right or could be wrong. Right? Let's utilize the conjunction or in some statements. We can go to the movies. We can stay at home. Two options. We can go to movie. We can stay at home. Let's use the conjunction Mr. Or. We can go to the movies. We can go to the movies. Or stay at home. We can go to the movies or we can stay at home. Let's see another example. Should I have my bath? Should I have dinner? Again, options. Let's use the conjunction or. Should I have my bath or dinner? Should I take a bath or have a dinner? This was the use or the function of the conjunction or. Moving ahead. Now, some more conjunctions are there. For example, so, then, as, etc. Let's take the conjunction so. What is the purpose of so? It shows that the second idea is a result of the first idea. That means two statements are there, right? The second idea, the second statement is the result of the first one. We did something, right? In the first statement we did something. The output of that action is the second statement. Let's use the conjunction so to get a better picture. Let's see the first example. My grandfather is coming to visit. My grandmother is coming to visit. My grandmother is coming to visit me. I have to go home early. I have to go home early. Now, let's use the conjunction so. My grandmother is coming to visit, so I have to go home early. Now, normally I used to go to home at the regular time, like 4 o'clock. But today my grandmother is coming to visit me or to meet me. Therefore, I have to go early. Because of the first statement, the second statement will be the result. I hope you got the idea. This is the action, this is the result. Ye hai, tabhi ye hoga. If my grandmother, the grandmother visits, right? Her visit has caused my early departure. Main tabhi pehle ja rahi hu, kyunki मेरी ग्रैंडमदर आ रही है. द सेकेंड वन इज द आउटकम और द रिजल्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट आइडिया. लेट्स सी अनदर एग्जांपल. आई डिड नॉट स्टडी. आई फेल्ड माय टेस्ट. लेट्स सी. लेट्स यूज द कंजंक्शन सो. आई डिड नॉट स्टडी सो आई फेल्ड माय टेस्ट. फर्स्ट आई डिड नॉट स्टडी. If you don't study, it's very obvious that you will fail the exam. See, the first action is the result of this. Is the second statement is the result of the first action. If you had studied, you could have passed the exam, but you didn't study. Therefore, you failed the test. I hope you understood the purpose of so. Let's take another example. I missed my bus. I was late for school. Let's use the conjunction so. I missed my bus, so I was late for school. First action gave the result, right? You come to school. Yeah, you come to school. Why were you late? Because you missed the bus. I missed the bus. That caused another conundrum or another situation. In that situation, I was late for school. Moving ahead. Now we are going to understand the purpose of the next conjunction as. What is the purpose of the conjunction as? Shows two events happening at the same time. It shows two events happening at the same time. Let's see. I saw my sister. I was leaving. Two statements. And it should be happening at the same time. I saw my sister as I was leaving. Like I was in a function. As I was leaving, I saw my sister. When I was like, for instance, let's say, when I was at the gate, at that time, I saw my sister. Same time. See, the time is same. When I am here, at that particular time or at that pinpoint, I saw my sister. See, the time is same. Moving ahead, let's see another example. I was playing the piano. This is not piano, piano. My grandmother was cooking. My mother was cooking. I was playing the piano as my mother was cooking. By the time when I was playing the piano, at the same time my mother was cooking something in the kitchen. The time is same. Now let's use another conjunction, then. What is the purpose of then? Shows that the second idea or action happens after the first. Right? The second thing will happen after the first. That means the first action will happen followed by the second action. Let's see some example to get a better picture. I finished my homework. I finished my homework. I cleaned my room. I finished my homework. I cleaned my room. Let's use the conjunction then. I finished my homework. Then cleaned my room. First, I finished my homework. What is the first action? I finished my homework. After finishing my homework, what did I do? I cleaned my room. First finished my homework, then cleaned my room. Let's see, if we can also use the conjunction and. Let's see what is the difference between then and. If we replace the conjunction then with and, let's see what happens. I finished my homework and cleaned my room. I finished my homework and cleaned my room. See, when we are using the conjunction then, we get the idea that first action, the finishing of homework, was before cleaning the room. Right? First I finished my homework, then I cleaned my room. But if we use the conjunction and, we will not get the idea what was done first. Did I clean the room first or did I completed my homework? I'm not sure which happened first. Right? By the use of conjunction, we can understand that first action happened after for or followed by the second action. Moving ahead. Let's see another example of conjunction then. I ate a burger. I ate a slice of cake. Let's use the conjunction then. I ate a burger, then a slice of cake. That means first I finished my burger. I was eating burger. I finished it. Then I started with the cake and ate it. First I finished my burger, then I ate the cake. Again, let's replace the conjunction then with conjunction and. I ate a burger and a slice of cake. From this statement, from this word, from this conjunction and, we did not get the idea what I ate first. Right? It's simply showing that I ate burger as well as I ate cake, a slice of cake. I had both of them. But I didn't get the idea which item I ate first. The then conjunction tells which item was first and which was second. Moving further. So, as, so, then, and, or, but. It is used to connect words, phrases, sentences to each other. These are the conjunctions which we have discussed thoroughly. These are used to connect what? Words, phrases and sentences to each other. So let's see some more conjunction. Because, for, just as, neither, nor, not only, so, whether, yet. These are some more examples of conjunction. Now we have the simple exercise. These are six sentences, six blanks. The first one is done for you. In this, we have one statement with a blank and we have three options in the bracket. You have to choose the best or the most suitable option for the blank. The first one is done for you. The rest is for you to practice. This concludes our session with English language. We hope that you learn something new every day. We hope for your well-being. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.